Hi, Internet friends. It's Tim Schrock at Design Build Solutions. On today's Tech Tip Tuesday, we're going to talk about page templates within our layout file in Chief Architect Premier X15. Let's get started. Thank you all so much for following along, for joining, for interacting with these videos. I enjoy the interaction very much, and I enjoy the comments and the questions. If you like this information, please leave encouragement by subscribing, hitting a like, hit the notification bell. And if you find it, you know, valuable, would you consider giving a small amount to paypal.me/designbuildsolutions? Thank you so much. So on today's tip, I want to talk about layout files and the page templates within that. This is not to be confused with the layout template that if you go a file, new layout, that's the template that pops up here. This is the page template within your individual layout file. Now, you can create multiple page templates within one layout file. By default, what happens is there is a template on page zero here of the file, and the rest of the pages typically take on that that formatting, that border, that information. Anything that's on page zero typically will show up in the rest of the pages. Right now, this draft not for construction is a watermark, so I'm going to turn that off. What precipitated me thinking about this particular file was, or this particular tutorial, was a question on Facebook regarding wanting to get draft notices on some pages, but not others. The quick way you could do that, I've got a draft notification here that's a text thing. Let's resize that. The quick way you could do that is put it on one page and copy it and put it on this page and go up to the next page and put it on the, you know, that page, or not this page. But there's another way you could do it as well. I'm going to Control X and Control-Alt-V, you'd be using Command-Option-V if you're using a Mac. And I'm going to drop this, use my layering and put it on the back layer. So any text that's on these pages is now in front of, if you will, this text that's on the background. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, on page one here, I'm going to insert a page before page one. So what was page one now becomes page two, and page one is blank. What I'm going to do is edit the page information. My toolbar, I've got it set up here. You can go to the menu, Tools, Layout, Edit Page Information. And I'm going to use this right here, use as page template. And I'm going to give this a title called template with, we'll call without draft. Okay. And notice, because I made this a page template, we'll go back here, use as page template right there. This is now blank. We've got a whole new blank template to work with. I'm going to select all of this information here that's on this page and copy it. Now, when I copy, you'll notice it says one or more items were not copied, the objects were not eligible for copy or placed in an incorrect location. The uncopied items were the sheet boundary. For some reason, we can select the sheet boundary, but you cannot copy it. And that's okay. It did not copy. It copied everything else. I'm now going to go up to what the file calls page one and Control-Alt-V for paste, hold position. Once again, on a Mac, that's Command Option V. And there is the information. Now, this page, we do not want the draft on here. The problem with using the watermark is that watermark then occurs on all of the pages. So I'm creating this template without the draft on there. And let's say I want, on the draft page, I don't want the revision table. Now, before I started this, I want to show you, I set this up so that the client is the client information macro and the contractor is the, not that one, the contractor is under the design macro. And you get to that by going to Tools, Designer, Client Information. You see ABC Company, I filled in the street address, client information, I filled in this information there, right? And by copying that macro over to this second template page, I don't have to edit the I don't have to edit the text in two locations to adjust the later on pages. Like for instance, I noticed, you know, this is supposed to be, the street address should be 456, not 4456. So what I'm going to do is going to Tools, Designer, Client Information, and change that here. And now that's updated on page one and page zero. On the page number, I've filled out Layout Label Macro. Okay, so from here, now this can get confusing. Because I have multiple page templates, my A1 is not going to be on page one. A1 here of my plan set is not going to be on page one up here. I have two template pages. So the first template page is page zero, and the second template page is page one. My plan set starts on page two in this file. All right, so I've got my templates set up. And all right, so this one is pulling from the draft. See, it has the draft on there and it does not have the revision. All of these pages are pulling from that page zero. Now, if I go here and I don't want A2 to be on the draft, I'm going to go back into my Tools, Layout, Edit Page Information, and I'm going to change the page template. This is the default page template, which was given that title by default. And notice, remember that title that I gave the second page template? Template without draft. There we go. It removed the draft because that's not on that template. But the revision table is. Notice, even though I change my page template, I'm going to go into this page. I use the pound sign to increment each page number. So a pound on every page will increment by one. A1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, ad nauseum. Okay. It doesn't matter what page template that will still honor that pound sign. The one thing I have noticed that might be a problem is I've got this macro down here. It's outside of the bounds of the border, so it doesn't print. But because it's on my template here, template page, it shows up. And this macro is a starter hash macro to start. So every time I copy this here, this will increment 1, 2, 3. So each of my details will increment by number 2 just by copying them in order. Just saves me a little extra time not having to increment those myself by text. There may be an issue with this macro by using multiple page templates, but that's not the purpose of this video. All right, so let's say we wanted to add a third type, like a minimalistic page layout. I'm going to go back to my page 2, and I'm going to go into my layout, and I'm going to insert a page before page 2. So what was page 2 in my layout file now becomes page 3, but it still remains A1 of my plan set. So back to page 2 and go into my layout page specification. And remember, I'm going to use this as a page template, and I'm going to call this minimalist. Notice, let's go back to page 0, edit page information. There's, remember, default page template that was in the drop-down list. That's where this is coming from. So I could say this is draft template, right? Oh, notice that changed. Let's go back to page 2. It does not get in, this page does not get included in the layout page table because it's a template. And if I go to this page, notice page template, I'm using the draft template. I'm not using the template without draft, and I'm not using minimalist. Okay. I could, from here, I could say none. I don't have to use a page template at all. And there's just the information that's on this page. Let's do draft template. Now our border comes back, and all of our client and contractor and title and page number and date information comes back, as well as our macros here. Okay. So let's go to page 3 and say this is a pound. Sketch minimal. And I want to, whoops, before I hit 0, I should have changed this to minimalist. Well, it's a blank page. That's because that minimalist page is still blank. So let's come here, and I'm going to select this information. And I'm going to copy just that. Command Option V. I'm going to delete this. I'm going to delete these items here. And I'm going to delete these as well. And I'm just going to take this exact same information and put it down here like so. Maybe I want to rearrange it. So A1 looks like this with the draft. A2 does not have the draft, but we put the revision table back on. And A3 has this minimalist page look. Has all the same information, but it's a different order, different layout, a different look altogether. And then if I wanted to change this, say it's the Smith. Oh, it's not Smith, it's Jones. Kitchen remodel. Now, notice Jones Kitchen Remodel shows up here. In order to change this information, Jones Kitchen Remodel is not looking correct here. I would have to go back to my minimalist plan and minimalist template and then stretch that out a little bit. Or maybe I'd go to my text style and say 0.15. There we go. But see, that didn't affect these two. It only affected this page here. So I'd have to go back to my each template. Instead, 3/16 is 0.1875, so 0.15, that works. And then that works. Now all of my pages in my plan set, A1 works, A2 works, A3 works. You know, I'd have to continue on. Now, instead of copying this draft as the example was, I could copy this draft onto pages 8, 9, 11, and 15 if I wanted. In this case, what I would do is 8, 9, 11, 15, I would choose a different template without draft. And there's that information. All right. So this, once again, a pound puts in the incremental page number, new page, and there's the information. I hope this is helpful. If you like this, learn something new, click subscribe, like, and hit the notification bell. Otherwise, have a wonderful week. I'll see you next time.